Next, we have my oldest puzzle. This is the Test Your Knowledge USA map. It's a 4x8 sliding puzzle, same as a 15 puzzle. This one is from 1966, so it looks and turns pretty good for a puzzle that old. And that's also one of the reasons why I bought it, because it's that old and it was pretty cheap. Just cool to have something that old in my collection. Next, we have this corner ledge cube, made by Vladimir Jaroslavskij. I don't think I pronounced it right, but it's custom made with these smart with these wings, so you can only turn it one layer like this, and the corner turning of the, because the these speed cubes these days are pretty pretty flimsy, it allows move clockwise but not counterclockwise, so it's actually pretty smart, and it was quite cheap, so it's cool to have a corner ledge cube together with my regular ledge cube. It has these arrows so you know where which way it can turn. Next, another puzzle I made myself. The idea was to make a Megamoid, which was made before by someone else, but I didn't really have the knowledge to actually mod. So instead, I glued the pieces together, and later asked Oliver from OliverStickers.com to make these bandage stickers for me. And well, this is the result. It's bandaged on each of the white side and the gray side. And it was a lot of fun to figure out to solve it myself. Well, I can recommend to make one yourself. It's not that hard. You simply have to glue these pieces together and put these stickers, and that's it. Next, another one of my mods, which looks a bit strange because I had to make these edges smaller. It's a Lenlen Void Cube, and you can see on the inside, I hope you can see it, on the inside it has these stickers on the inside, so you basically have to look through it to solve it. Let me just turn like this. So you can see it has on the inside of the corners and on the of the edges. So that's on each of the sides. So that's how you should solve it. Because you have to look through it, I call it kaleidoscope 3x3x3, which it basically has the same characteristics as a void cube. It's also the void parity and such, but. The reason I had to make these edges a bit smaller was so the stickers wouldn't be removed again. It was very tidy. So every time, even if I just make one 360 degree move, it would already just completely destroy the stickers. So that's why I had to cut each of the edges. Then I went to Dutch Cubing Day for the first time this year. I mainly went to meet people from the Twisted Puzzles forum. That was my initial goal, but of course I couldn't leave empty-handed. The Cubing Day is not only a place to meet other people that cube, also to see the speed cubers there, but it's mainly a market to buy puzzles. So yes, I did obviously buy some puzzles. One of them I was actually looking for when I went there was this Brain Twist, which is basically a pyramid like this. You can move these tips, and the cool part is you can then turn it upside down and again move the tip, so you have to solve both the inside and outside. Yeah, I was looking for one, so I was glad I found one, and it was only something like €3, so yes, it's a lot of cheap puzzles there, so that's pretty cool. I also bought this topspin, I believe. Yes, topspin, which has these numbered pieces 1 to 20. And there's one you can flip them upside down like this, and that's how you scramble and solve it. And it turns very good. I also have this quite big backspin, which has these balls on one side and also on the other that you have to solve. And there's one hole, so you can move the balls from one side to another. And I also bought this small Reshki 2. There are three versions. This is the second version. Basically has one completely yellow circle and one partially and half moon red circle. It well, it moves like these two layers. Even though it only has these two colors, it's still well, not as easy as it looks. I also bought this Rubik's World, which was actually one of the few puzzles I regret buying. The main reason is well, it's very stiff, that for one. But the main reason is this edge is upside down. Someone must have disassembled it in 1982. That's where it's from, as you can see right here. Zoom. But yeah, when this edge is flipped and it's so stiff and well old that I'm not able to take it out or even remove screws or anything. So yeah, it's a bit of a bummer. But oh well, I can't change that now. Next we have this fun looking virus puzzle. It's also a 15 puzzle where you can move the pieces, but in addition you have these well, legs of the spider, that a six-legged spider, okay, not really a spider then, but which are getting in the way and can well, be tangled, so that makes the solve just slightly more interesting, and it just looks very cool. Also, one fun thing about it is it's 3D, 3D, glow in the dark, I mean. So this part right here and the eyes, and also this middle part, the server, glow in the dark. So that also took me by surprise. And the last one I got from the Dutch Gaming Day is this Whirligig Plate 9 puzzle. I saw one in one of the other stands. And when I asked for the price, it was something like 60 euros. So I was like, no thanks. But then I came across another one, and it was just only 2 euros. It has this scratch right here, and also a missing part here. But yeah, if it's just 2 euros, the puzzle's still completely functional. It's a very easy puzzle, so I don't really know why on the other stand it was worth so much. But yeah, for just 2 euros, I couldn't just let it stay there. So those were the puzzles I bought. These puzzles I bought at Dutch Gaming Day. I also had a lot of fun. I will definitely go next year again. And now let's continue. Then someone else on the Twisted Puzzles forum was selling his collection again. And of course, with just amazing prices, I couldn't let some of them pass. So from Galcam of the Twisted Puzzles forum, I bought this Professor Pyraminx. Professor Pyraminx was out of stock almost everywhere, on, so I was glad I bought this one. Not in the greatest shape, although it is signed by Timur Evbatyrov, which made the puzzle. This exceeds just some small damages, but because of that, I had a huge discount. So and it still functions completely normal. So I'm glad I bought it. Another one I have is this Jinx Spellwings. Again, a puzzle that is sold out almost everywhere. And again, I had a huge discount just because of this small blue sticker that was slightly damaged. But turning is just great, and so I don't mind the discount just because one sticker is only slightly damaged. Also, this Curvicopter Plus. I showed the Curvicopter before, so you can make a move like this. And you can also just move one. Compared to a regular Curvicopter, this is where it would be bandaged, because these extra cuts you can still make moves like this, which well, makes the solve a lot harder. And also the scramble. The first time I had this, I just jumbled it way too much and it was just unturnable, so I was forced to take it apart, assemble it again, and jumble it a bit less, so I was still able to turn it. And so yeah, be careful when you scramble this one a bit too much. Next is MF8 Master Killerwinx, which the Gigaminx that I showed earlier was the 5-layered version of the Megaminx, and this is the 4-layered version. So same as a 4x4x4, it has no physical center. But again, the turning is just great. It's basically just a new puzzle, but still cheaper there because it used to be from someone else, Galcom. So yeah, it's great to add it to my collection. Again, a puzzle. All of these four puzzles were out of stock on most places. I also bought this Pyromorphinx. I already had two. When I saw this one, I thought originally thought it was a junior Pyromorphinx, so you can only turn these tips. But it said it's just a Pyromorphinx, so a 2x2 shape mod. Turning is very bad, but well, it was only $1, so I was, why not? And it's also Dutch again, so that's also yeah, pretty cool to have something from my own home country in my collection. I also bought this what's it called? Telefonchik, I believe. It's a Russian puzzle. Has these balls right here and also in the inside. I won't turn it because then it's completely scrambled. You can see two of the light blue balls here, and it's also on the inside. And you can basically move both of these wheels. And this one still came in its original factory plastic, so that's also another bonus. Next we have this Even Less Gears from Oscar van Deventer. I showed the GearCube before and also the GearCube Extreme. As you remember, GearCube Extreme had one regular layer. This one has two. It does make the solve a lot harder, at least it was for me. I had quite a lot of trouble solving this. Luckily I had help from two different people of the Twisty Puzzles forum. One even made a video just for me personally, so I that was really cool of him, and I was able to solve it eventually. And also one puzzle I saw at Dutch Cubing Day was this one. It's basically a 2x2 on the outside and a 3x3 on the inside, and it looked very cool to me. So I went looking if it was still available, and well, it turned out it was. You can buy this one at RedEden.com. It's called the Bandits Red 2 version 1 Magic Cube. It's a mouthful, but that's how they call it. It's basically, like I said, a 2x2 on the outside and a 3x3 on the inside. And one of the corners, I believe it's this white blue corner. When I turn this layer, it moves only this part, but these two stay fixed. Same for this white one, this moves, these stay fixed, and the blue one, this moves, these stay fixed. So basically, you have this 2x2x2 bandaged block here, and so it solved. It solves the same as a fuse cube or Siamese 8 bandage block. So I first made it with my bandage kit that I showed earlier to know how to solve it. And then it was basically the same solve on this one. We now come to the conclusion of my collection, which with the puzzles I've added in the last 2 months. One of them was this 6-eyed Rex cube. As I mentioned before, I really liked the Rex cube. And one afternoon I was having this idea from with eyes, because these petals really look already like eyes, so I thought it would be cool to have a sticker mod of it. So I contacted Oliver Stickers with my ID, and also with the request of making one purple and one gray, because it's, well, gray is better to for eyes than white, and I really like purple eyes. So he did an excellent job of making these, and these are my me and Oliver's own cube. So they are still available at Oliver Stickers, so if you want one yourself you can buy it. But the original idea was by me, and it turned out great. The solve isn't that much harder than a regular Rex cube. It's just you have to deal with center orientation at the end, and solving the pieces takes a bit longer, but no new algorithms for the pedals are needed. But it really looks, turned out great. Next we have this Roto 36 by Galen Ivanov, as you can see right here. Originally he has three puzzles for sale, rotating circle puzzles. One of them is this one, which has these circles, these three circles that can turn, and also one big circle in the middle to interchange pieces. But after seeing the good quality when this one arrived, and also how fun it was to solve, I contacted him for the other two puzzles as well, which are the Vitro puzzle, with these strange cuts like this. It's actually a lot easier than it looks. At first I thought this would be the hardest of the three, but this one is actually easier than this next one, which is the number swing. The number swing has these numbers 0 to 9. I was able to solve one circle. And you also have to solve these small pieces. You have these pieces to move them around. Like this. And but I'm, as you may have noticed, it's not solved yet. The blue circle is still unsolved. I haven't been able to find the tree cycle yet. But hopefully I we'll be able to solve it in the near future. But excellent quality puzzles, and also not that pricey. It's, I believe they were only 20 euros per puzzle, so that's very reasonable considering it's not a mass produced puzzle, but custom made. So that's I'm really glad I bought these. Next we have this purple metallized David Pitcher cube. When it was released in black, blue, and white, I didn't bought it right away, and now I'm glad I didn't, because when the purple one arrived I was like, okay, I just gotta have a metallized purple one instead. It's also I believe it's out of stock already. It was also available in gold, silver, metallized blue, and metallized pink. But the purple one looked best to me. And they came unstickered, but again I asked all of the stickers for stickers on them, because well then it's dissolve is harder and it also looks cooler to me personally. It's a pretty confusing puzzle. A lot of people think at first it's just 3x3x3 shape mod, but it's definitely not. It's actually a shape mod of the another puzzle by David Pitcher. I'm not really sure which one, to be honest. But it's a lot harder than just a regular 3x3 shape mod, but still turned very good. Great puzzle. Next we have this mini geranium, again unsolved. These are puzzles I have only added in the last 2 months to my collection. Haven't really got the time for this one yet. I did manage to solve the bigger pieces, but the small ones, the small triangles, I still need to solve. But yeah. Next, I really wanted a 3D printed puzzle to my collection. So I contacted David Pitcher, who also made this one. Which is, this is one of his few mass-produced puzzles. And I contacted David Pitcher to really make a considerate decision. I made a top 5 or top 10, something like that. Ask his opinion of each of the puzzles, like how good is the quality, how difficult or easy are they, stuff like that. And eventually I had only a few left. At the end I decided for one puzzle. I let him do the assembling and lubing, tensioning, stickering as extra service. Did cost a bit more because of that, but it was worth it in my opinion. So that was the idea for my first 3D printed puzzle. During Cyber Monday it was just a nice discount of 20% and also free shipping. So I bought one of his other puzzles, which is this fully functional 2x2x2, Siamese 2x2x2. It may look like just a regular 2x2x2 Siamese cube. So it's basically two cubes bandaged on one by two part. But the cool thing about this puzzle is that you can make this middle move like this. I have to hold the puzzle correctly like this, and you can actually interchange pieces from one cube to another. Really cool concept. I'm definitely hoping they'll make a 3x3 version once available for sale. So for example we have this these two red yellow cubes. When I move one here and one here and then do the move, we actually have them well on the same QB, which it's a really cool concept, and I'm glad I bought this one. So this was actually my first 3D printed puzzle by David Pitcher. And then this one arrived, the which I'm still trying to figure out how to solve. As you can see, it says parity, so two pieces that need to swap. I have no idea yet how to do that. But this is the Fracture 12. This is the puzzle I finally decided on after careful consideration. Has these, normally you only move in increments of 180 degrees like this. But sometimes when you have symmetry like this, you can make 90 degree moves. And because David Pitcher himself tensioned and looped the cube and also finished sticker it and also sign it, just everything. It did cost a bit more, but well, I was I'm glad I bought it, and hopefully I will be able to solve it soon. The turning is just great, especially for a 3D printed puzzle. They're also very light. I was kind of surprised they were. I mean, I did expect them to be light, but they were a lot lighter than I originally thought they would. So yes, I'm really glad I got these two. Also check out David Pitcher's shape paste shop. I put the link in the description because he has a lot of amazing puzzles. This is one of his puzzles that is mass-produced, and the Octo Star is also one of them, which I hope to add to my collection soon. But I really hope more of his puzzles will be mass-produced, because they're just amazing. Next we have this 4x4 shape mod. This is Master Morphings, or no, Mega Morphings, sorry. Which is basically a four-layered version of the Master Morphings puzzle. And yeah, it's by Moju, so the turning is just great. This is the light blue version. I bought it from Z-Cube Dutch dot HQ, HK. Well, from Z-Cube. So it was well, quite cheap. At the same time, I also bought an actual transparent cube this time, which was the transparent Guanlong, Yongyong Guanlong, that I also used for my the beaded fishing line with the ironing beads that I showed before. To mod, and now this one is a lot more see-through than the troll cube I showed before. So I made this well, snake cube. It, again, not solved yet. It has all these snakes heads and tails sticking out everywhere, and it just turns like a regular 3x3. Oh, this piece is bandaged. And these three pieces are bandaged because it's together like this. But it's really cool to have a transparent cube, and I probably make a few more versions with something else inside of it. I'm not sure yet what I will put inside next, but it's a cool concept. And last but not least, my latest puzzle that just arrived today, to be honest, is this Rubik's hat. I have seen the Rubik's hat before for sale. Usually it's around 80 to 120 US dollars, but during the auction I found on the German eBay, I was able to buy it for just 40 euros. So yes, I'm really glad I did. It's a cool puzzle. You have to look through it. As you can see, there's no rivets right here. Let me just solve it real quickly. If I remember correctly, it should be solved like this. It's not really visible. Well, actually you have to look through it, and then you see all the rivets on the other side. It's not really showing in the camera, to be honest, which is unfortunate. Yeah, that's how you solve it, and it's mainly just a collector piece. A lot of people would love to have one in their collection, and I'm glad I have. It's just yeah, cool shape, cool collector's item, and I also bought it pretty cheap. A small update. It turns out I forgot about two puzzles. One of them is this Lan Lan lizard sticker mod with Escher kind stickers. It's not that hard to solve, but it looks very looks fun, especially with this Escher type sticker mod. I bought this at the same time as the Red Eden 3x3x9 I showed earlier at rededen.com. And another one I forgot to mention was this Furry Puzzle Superstar. When I bought it, I was under the impression that the stickers would come loose, so I could stick it myself, and I would stick it in the same kind of with the same colors next to each other, like my Eden Star. But it came pre-stickered. At first it was a kind of bit of a bummer, but I don't mind that much now anymore, because like this it looks very confusing, and it's a real eye catcher, especially to non-cubers. This one really catches their eye if they step into my room. It has 32 sides, so it's actually an edge-only Tuttminx. And now you solve it with the, by looking at the outsides here. So this one is the green side, and the pink, yellow, purple, etc. So that can be a pretty confusing solve. And it came with this package material, which I use as a stand. Pretty convenient. Then it was Christmas time 2 days ago, and I received this Kuji tiled Pyraminx crystal, which turns like this. And yeah, it's a fun little puzzle. Turns pretty good. I've seen some bad reviews with these pieces sliding around everywhere, and if you try it a bit too quick, then it still happens, as you can see right here. But if you just be careful, then then it should be fine. So it doesn't have any corner cutting, but the turning is pretty good. So this one I received for Christmas. I also received the Megawinx, which I will use for another mod and show later. And one last quick update was this snake's cube that I previously short scrambled, and it solved again. It was actually not that hard. It's basically a bandaged cube with this 1x2 bandage block, and this 1x3, I mean, and this 1x2 bandage block, and the rest is just a regular Rubik's cube, and it has these snakes inside of it. On all three layers. So yeah, I've ordered two more transparent cubes, and I will make some more, some other different 3D mods. So that yeah, that was it. That was the quick update. So that's the conclusion of my entire collection. I will now show an overview of every puzzle on the shelves. And I hope, well, everyone that stayed for the entire thing, watched everything, I want to thank you. I know my pronouncing is pretty bad. I hope it it wasn't too bad to listen to. Perhaps you could have some background music would make it more enjoyable. And well, I will now show an overview of my everything. All the puzzles on the shelves, and thanks for watching. Next video I will probably be a tutorial for the Cubo puzzle that I showed, and I will most likely, I'm not entirely sure yet, but also make a scramble video where I scramble all these puzzles I just showed. I will all scramble them, so definitely stay tuned for that. When it will come, I don't know yet, but I will probably will, mainly because some puzzles I've only solved once, like Eaton Star or the Granium puzzle, so it's cool to force myself to scramble everything and solve them once again. Although I probably first try to solve these four puzzles to start with, so it might take a while before that video comes up, but yeah. Once again, thanks for watching, and have a nice day.